Let's first of all deal with what exactly is a herniated disc.
So a herniated disc is when that nucleus or gel within the disc starts to migrate out beyond the edges of the disc. And you can see in the graphic here that the inner core of the disc, this is a slice through the disc, the inner core is migrating out and it's touching the nerve right there where it's red and yellow.
Could you use the cursor right there? You have the pad right there.
Certainly. So you can see this is the disc. It should be contained within this outer band, this connective tissue band, and it should be round all the way around. You can see that the gel, and it actually, in surgery, it actually looks like crab meat in a young, healthy disc. And you can see that it's migrated out and it's pushing on this nerve. And it's going to cause what's called sciatica. Sciatica essentially is the irritation of the nerve by something, either the disc or the bone behind it, pushing on it, squeezing it, and causing pain down the leg. That is what sciatica is. It follows the distribution of the largest nerve called the sciatic nerve. And that's how that works. So in this case, this is the herniated disc pushing on it, causing sciatica. And people that are obese have higher risk of injuring this disc. And so that's what I was talking about earlier. I also mentioned these joints back here called the facet joints. If they get stressed, then they start to have these spurs that come off of them, and that can push from behind on the nerve as well, causing the same sciatica. So I tell patients, going back to your former question, Ed, I tell them, baby steps. Let's lose a few pounds at a time. I give an analogy. 1 pound of excess weight here is equivalent to about 30 pounds of force on the back. So if they can lose 5 pounds, that's a huge opportunity to decrease the load on the back.